Yo, what's good, guys? Welcome back to part number 3 of the Pendulum Database. Let me know what you guys think so far of this little series. I want to get through all the Pendulum cards in the world for it. And we got a whole bunch, man. There's a whole bunch of cards, whole bunch of Pendulum monsters, whole bunch of spells, whole bunch of traps, etc., etc. Let me know if you guys want it in a vlog form. I prefer to do it in a vlog form, but too many of you guys seem to just want Yu-Gi-Oh! So this video is just going to be only Yu-Gi-Oh! With no vlog, nothing. But let me know if you guys like the vlog part, because I love adding a little vlog part so you guys see little bits of the Pendulum life as well. So let me know if you guys want that. I will happily add that in, but I'm not for this video because I want to see what you guys like more. Now, without further ado, part number 3 of our Pendulum database. Let's go. We left off the last video with Thomas. So we're now on page number 3. Gonna finish this and we're gonna try and go through it quick. Maybe we can finish page 3 and 4 today, but let's go. So, DDD Chaos King Apocalypse. For those of you who don't know what this card does, you can banish 2 DD monsters from your graveyard, special summon this card from your Pendulum Zone. This is not a bad effect. It's okay. During your opponent's turn, if this card is in your hand or grave, target 2 faces, spells, or traps you control. Can I special summon for feed the rest of the turn? If you do, special summon this card. Any effect that says, can I special summon monster for the rest of the turn except feed monsters sucks. I hate that part. The scale effect is too much. 2, not 1. If it was 1 DD, I'd like it. 2, not enough. I don't like the card. We're not playing it. It's not good enough. Next. Actually, you know what? No, we're going to put the Apocalypse card in the side deck. Because if we have enough DDs in the deck, maybe it can find some use. Because at the end of the day, any card that turbos itself is a good card. If you can find some use to put a bunch of DDs in great for free, maybe you can find some use. Next, DD Destiny King Zero Laplace, or however you pronounce that one. During your main phase, you can add 1 face-up DD Pendulum from your extra deck to your hand. Enough said, we're playing this one. There's definitely some use for it. You can special summon this card from your hand by tripping a DD monster, etc., etc., some attack bulls. Alright, we are playing this card. Why? Because it's a free plus 1. Any card that's a free plus 1, you're playing it. No questions asked. You play it if it's a free plus 1 without any questions asked. Next, we got DDD Doom King Armageddon. Now, we're going through a bunch of DD cards. There's lots of stuff to read. But this card, the Pendulum Effect, anything that just affects attack and nothing else. If it's not a plus 1, it just affects attack. I don't care about it. So Pendulum Effect deals, gives attack to a card. Monster Effect, once we're turning, a monster you control, destroy a battle or card effect, target one of those monsters, gains attack, garbage. Cannot be destroyed by spouses, traps, so do not target this card. Garbage card. Don't play it. Next, DD Oblivion King Abyss Ragnarok. If you special summon a DD monster, you can target a DD monster in your grave. Any battle damage your opponent takes is half, special summon that target. It's a Pendulum. Special summons the cards plus. We're putting it in. We don't even need to read the monster effect, but we will anyways. If this card is normal or special, target a DD monster in your graveyard, special summon it. Say no more. Ragnarok, you're in the deck. You're a good card. DD Oblivion King Abyss Ragnarok is a good card. This and Laplace together could have some use. I could see combos already utilizing both of these cards. And there's definitely the sky's the limit with these cards. Next, DD Rebel King Leonidas. We are putting this in without even thinking. There's too many FTK bullshit going around. We are going to add Leonidas in it and find some use to protect ourselves from all these FTKs. Especially the Cannon Soldier FTKs. There's just too many FTKs going around, which we're not going to deal with and we don't like. So we are going to definitely play Leonidas. In fact, we're going to be siding triple Leonidas against all the FTK decks and Brickstars for an even easier W. Next, a Pendulum Synchro. Like I told you guys before, any Pendulum extra deck card, we're adding in without even reading. There's always going to be use for these cards, so we're putting all of them in. If there's some form of Pendulums in the extra deck, we are putting them in because I know there's going to be extra use for them in the future. We can just easy ways to bring them out. And after you find easy ways to bring it out, it's incredibly easy to bring it out again after you find easy ways to bring it out the first time. So why on earth would you not want to play Pendulums from the extra deck? We're just free boss monsters for free. Next, this card's an OCG card, but let's see how good it actually is. Pendulum Effect. Target a face-up monster in the field. Change his defense to 0. No one cares about that effect. Monster effect now. If this card attacks the opponent, blah, blah, blah. Piercing damage. Don't care. Sucks. Let it be TCG or OCG sucks. Next, look what we got here. Dark Doriado, baby. It's our boy or girl. Definitely a girl. My bad. We are playing Dark Doriado. There's two genders. Next, Despot 5. Now, Despots are interesting. Because your Pengard over here may or may not have a Despot Pendulum build ready to show to the world. But, hey, in due time. Now, my version is missing a few cards to make it consistent, but there is potential with the Despot cards. They are all Pendulums, and a lot of them have plus ones. So Despots are a card, are an archetype that people don't look at for Pendulums just because they do their own little thing. They have to, they OTK people, etc., etc. But look at these cards. They all have effects. They're all plus one cards. So Despot 5-1 is normal special, destroy the spell or trap. So monster effect. This card normal special, target a spell or trap on the field, destroy it. Now, I know that if it's in the scale, you can only pendulum Despots. But that's all you only put in the scale if it's an absolute dire situation and you have a bunch of Despots in hand, unbricking your hand of Despots. So it's okay. The point is just a plus one. Next, I want you guys to read this part. This is also extremely important for the Despot Pendulum cards. If this card in the Pendulum zone is destroyed, target a Despot in your grave, special summon it. Plus ones, there's a lot of cool plays you do where you special summon a whole bunch of cards worth playing 100%. I'm not even putting it in the side area because there's a lot of cool Despot combos, which I'm going to show you guys. It's worthy of putting in your database. Next, Despot 06. Similar effects. If this card's normal or special, target a monster field change battle position. Don't care so much for that effect, even though it could help. But if this card's pendulum is destroyed, target a Despot card in your grave, add it to your hand. Another plus. Don't forget how many cards destroy cards in the scales. We got Electrum. We got Sky Iris. We got a whole bunch of different ways. Terraformings to get the Iris. Whole bunch of different ways. Pendulum performed by Sorcerer to destroy cards in the scales to get pluses. Don't forget that. So we are definitely adding Despot 6 to pair with Despot 5. Now, any Despot we see in the future, whether it be a Pendulum or not a Pendulum, we need, if it coincides with the effects of Despot 5 and Despot 6, we're going to put it into our database. Because it's gonna, when we go through our database to deck build, gotta tell you deck build. You go through your database, look at sick cards. We're eventually at the end going to pair together all the cards that are similar. For example, we're going to pair the Magicians together, the Despots together, the DDs together, etc., etc. And we are going to find sick combos as we go along. That's how I invent all my combos in my head. I'll go through my database, and I put cards together. I see combos, test a little, and boom, I got it. And then I throw a few combos together, and you got yourself a deck. So, it must be done. Now, the next Despot we're going to be looking at, Despot 7. So, this one gains a bunch of attack, blah, blah, not that good. Don't play it. I know it's a Despot card, but we're not going to play that one. Next, look at Despot 8. Similar, has a bunch of attack, like attack twice type of effects. We don't care about attack effects. More so, we care about plus ones. Not worthy of playing. We don't play any of those. Next, Darmine Magician. It's a magician that's a level 7. Kind of sucks, but we're going to add it anyways because it's a magician. It's a magician. I understand it sucks, but it's a level 7 magician. You could always see some play with it. And has the opportunity to be both a low skill and high skill. Opportunity to be a low skill and high skill might be worth playing. Especially if you're going to be playing Despots, because you can reveal a card in your hand. So once you reveal one Pendulum monster in your hand, then target one Magician card in your Pendulum zone, the scale becomes that. So if you're playing a bunch of Despots with this, you put this in the scale, reveal one of the scale 10s, and now this becomes scale 2 or scale 10, or the other Magician is scale 2 or scale 10, it could come clutch, worthy of having. Next, especially if you're going to play a bunch of cards that say, you can't append to summon monsters except Despots or except DDs, because DDs have that as well with Kepler. Just show the Kepler in your hand, or show a Despot in your hand, and when this is in your scale, and that one of the Magicians will become skill 10, which is huge. You can append summon the level 8 DDs, etc., etc. Now, next we're going to go on to Dynamists. Now, Dynamists are a very good deck. They are very underrated, and people don't play them. They have a lot of plus 1 cards, and they're good. So without further ado, we're adding Demoness Brachion right off the bat. It's a turbo card when you go second, and you could use it more than once per turn, and you don't need that monsters on field. In fact, you could keep looping it over and over as long as you get in your hand. I'm gonna show you a cool little combo when I showcase Dynamites in action by themselves. Now, Demoness Echolos sucks. We don't play this one. Demoness Ceratops, interesting. We're gonna play this one. If we're gonna play a bunch of Demoness in it, you might as well play Ceratops because Again, all the skill effects are relatively the same, but the monster effect, if all Dynamis monsters you control are, if all monsters you control are Dynamis, and none are Ceratops, special summon this card from your hand. So if you use special Brachion than this, you got yourself two free level 5 special summons. It's nice. And it does help that they're all level 5 machines, so it'll help you go into infinity if you play a bunch of them. So it is clutch for that reason. Next, we got Dynamis Plesios. This card sucks, don't play it. Now, we are around 10 minutes in the video. We're going to finish the Dynamis and then go... We're going to finish the Dynamis and then finish the video. But the next one... You know what? We're going to finish 3 or 4 today. Screw it. We're finishing the 3rd and 4th page. Let's go. Dynamis Pteron. When this card destroys a monster by battle, add a Dynamis card from your deck to your hand. If it's 1800 attack, too many low attack monsters, all the Sky Strikers suck. We're playing this just in case on the side area if we're going to play a bunch of Dynamis. Next, Dynamis Rex. It's very important for Dynamis to play this card. Not so important for us to play this card, but we're going to put it in the side anyways if we're going to focus on Dynamis. We're going to put Ceratops on the side area as well. If we play Dynamis, we throw them in. Next, Dynamis Spinos. Sucks, don't play this one. Next, Dynamis Stegosaur. Sucks, don't play this one. Double Iris, my boy, come back to us. We're putting this in the side along with the boy Astro in the hopes that it comes back. Next, Dragoni's Empowered Warrior. You need to play this in case you want to play Empowerment, the field spell, because it gives you a... if you have a lot of discard outlets, you discard a plus one and get a free turbo card and then pop the field spell with Electro. So this is definitely mandatory to have in a database if you ever want to play a Dragonhorn Hunter. Buy Dragon Caller Magician. Buy... Yeah, I know. Another Magician. Actually, it's a Magician we're going to put it. Whatever. Next is the other level 7. You never know. Dark Light. You never know when we want to play a little Armageddon deck. Any deck, any card that has an opportunity to be good, you play just in case. That's what the database is for. To have any card you might play in the future, so you never need to look at any other card again. Next, Dragong. We're not playing no normal Pendulum Bull. We don't play that. We're not playing those. Dragonox is just another Empowered Warrior that you bring out. Another Pendulum you bring out with Empowerment, the field spell, which I will show you guys in the future. Empowerment is a discarded card, special an Empowered Warrior from your deck. It's a great card. So two Pendulums, Turbos, boom. Next, Dragon, the boys, the OGs, Dragon Pit, and Dragon Pulse. We are most definitely throwing these in. Respect to Dragon Pit and Dragon Pulse, the OG Magicians. We are not going to sleep on them. They both have great effects. Destroy a monster, destroy a spell or trap. Destroy, like, it's too good. It just, so much utility. To the Magicians have too much utility. That's why I love them. You could, if these are in your deck, you can destroy a monster or a spell anytime you want, or a spell or trap anytime you want. So it is fantastic. Next, Dragoons of Draconia. This is going to be in here for a Beast Warrior skill when Broadwell comes back, just in case. Edgem Cotton Eater. Now this is going to all fright for fusion monsters, fusion summon to your field as a skill, draw a card. And it's a, you know what? You guys want to see Fluffle Pendulums? Why not? We're going to put this on the side for the situation where we do build Fluffle Pendulums. Again, a bunch of Trickstar Candina Garnets over here. We're not going to be playing them, even though these are better than Candina. Next, Fluffle Angel. Fluffle Angel, let's see if Fluffle's Fluffle Pendulums will have a chance in the future. You can talk about Fluffle, Edge Monster in your graveyard, special summon it. Whoa! You guys, special summon monster for the extra deck for the rest of this turn. You can tribute this card, target a fright for monster in your grave, discard a card, special summon. Say less. We are putting this in the little Fluffle area, and we're now putting Edge Cotton Eater up a little. You know what? Forget the side area, man. We're just going to coincide everything together. Forget it. Everything goes together. We're going to organize it better in the future. But I just want a database of good Pendulum cards, like Seto Kaiba's briefcase. But we're going to have 5 of these. So this is the first game plan database. We're going to have 5 game plan databases when it's all said and done of all the good one-up Pendulum cards. And then whenever we want to look back and build a deck, we're just going to look at these cards and build it from then. Now, next, Focal's Cannon. It is a summoner's target, which could be some of these as well. But garbage, don't play it. Next, Fright for Meister. This card looks sick. Damn. You can tribute one level 4 Lord Fluffle, Fright for Edge Jam, special summon a Fiend Monster. Special summon a Fiend Monster from your deck with the same level of tributed monster. What? A Fiend Monster? There's millions of Fiend Monsters in the world. What the heck? During your main phase, you can press them in 1 level 4 or lower Fumble Fight for engine from your deck. As you can press the monster for the rest of the deck, except you can tribute 2 or more fiend monsters. Press them. Holy shit! What the hell is this card broken? This card's broken! Holy crap! Frightfurmeister's broken! Holy shit! What? This card's absolutely busted! You could special summon this card with Chronograph easily during your main phase, special summon, and at the end of your turn, when you're done your turn, when you're done your negates, you special summon a Fumble Fright for engine monsters from your deck, and then as you can't special summon except fusion monsters, but then after you bring it out, you make a fusion. This card's busted. And then you can tribute 2 more fusions, special summon a Fright from your extra deck. Oh! And the skill effect's the most busted of all. Tribute a level 4 or lower Fumble Fright for engine, no problem. Special a fiend from your deck. Are you kidding me? A fiend. Not a Fuffle Fiend or a Frightfur Fiend. A fiend. A fiend. Any fiend. Any fiend from your deck with the same level. This card's busted. Fluffle Pendulums coming the second this card comes out on the TCG. I never even saw this card in my life. I'm Googling this right now. Frightfurmeister. When are you coming to me? I'm building a deck for you right now. Frightfurmeister. This card's busted. Release date. I see a bunch of OCG. I don't care about no OCG, man. When's coming on TCG? Okay. Never. Huh? Frightfurmeister. Oh my god. So they look like OCG promos or something. Wow, man. This is... Whoa! What? The Predapod Pendulum! This card's busted too! This card's busted too! During the end phase. But still, if it's got no more special, this card a plant, add a little... end phase. Never mind, it's not that busted. I thought you could use it before. But this card is busted! This card right here is busted. I'm making that the thumbnail. This card's absolutely broken. Holy crap, I'm in awe right now. Frightfurmeister, holy... I'm putting this at the very top over here. This card is something else. I'm building a deck revolving around Frightfurmeister. That's how good that card is. Next, Ghost Beef, go away. And that's it. That's it for the first 4 pages. So we did it. We finished 2 pages today. Hope you guys like this type of video. Let me know in the description if you guys want to vlog before. I want to do some vlog and some of this. But we're going to finish every single Pendulum card ever made in existence with this series. Pendulum card, spell card, trap card, non-Pendulum type of card that helps Pendulums. Any card that helps Pendulums we're going to feature on this series until we finish the whole database. And then, when all that's said and done, together as a family, the Pen God and the Pen family, we are all going to look at all these databases together, all 500 cards, and we're going to create every single great Pendulum creation known to mankind. We're going to build 50 Pendulum decks from this database. This database is the structure. It is the base of the pyramid. It is the base of building a Pendulum deck. So we're now building the base, going back to the basics, with our database. I hope you guys like this video. Make sure to like, comment, subscribe. Check out my second channel below. And for those of you that are still watching 20 minutes in, shout out to you guys, the OGs. Leave a little comment in below if you're still watching. Little news for you guys. I'm releasing my merch shop very, very soon. It's going to be big. Releasing Stick to the Game Plan shirts. Releasing our own Pendulum mat in conjunction with a new partner, which we're going to also announce once it's released, and it is going to be absolutely incredible. So, hope you guys liked the video. See you guys in tomorrow's video. Peace.